great links to Trig Point. And this is one of the highest points, as I keep saying, in the south of England. This is said to be the most beautiful tour in Dartmoor, which I definitely think I agree with. I hope. You join me from Brat's tour at, I can't remember the name of the cross, but hello, which way should I go down? Actually, I'm going to go around this way. Yeah. Hello there, folks. It's your Dartmoor National Park host on Dartmoor on a late autumn's day. I wild camped, as you can see. Hello there, folks. It's your host, Richard, for Dartmoor National Park. Not really doing any particular hike, I'm just doing random hikes around Dartmoor, really. And oh, I can see the red flags by, that means I can't go up to certain places, so I can go up to the cross, I think. But I don't know if you can hear that, but that's automatic rifles, automatic weapons. There's an army training ground up here, and the red flag's up, so they're doing training. I know there's a firing range where they use live ammunition. I can't even say that word. Live rounds. And there's a bit where they use they fire blank. They use blanks, but there is a firing range where they use proper rounds. I don't know if that's over there. I can hear the weapons going off. I think I'm okay camping up where I'm going. Walking up to Brat Tor, the cross. I'm hoping to camp there tonight, but I'm actually carrying over 40 kilos on my back today. Yeah, not too far to the top. Not serious wind, but apparently tomorrow could be quite serious. Fucking shit spots to hit the fan tomorrow, so. It's just too big, even for a small tent. I think you have to have a seriously small tent. It's just nice, no bits, that smooth. Brat Tor, and I'll take you the tour of where I'm camping. Take you on a tour around where I'm camping. So there's where I'm putting the tent. It's the only place out of the wind I could find that could actually put a tent up on that size. Just making some noodles and coffee while camping at Brat Tor. It's going to be 60 mile per hour winds tonight. Wind gusts. The wind speed of about 30 miles per hour. So 7:24 in the morning. Sunrise still hasn't happened. Sunrise is at 7:42. I'm up at Brat Tor, top of Brat Tor by the cross. Four season winter tent down in the wind. I've shouted for the wind a bit. This is up to 60 per hour gusts. is supposed to be up to 16 miles per hour, so we'll play it safe and go to the campsite. Shit, can you hear the wind? I don't know if you can see that. I don't know if you can hear it. But yeah. So, we got like 60 mile per hour gusts apparently. Wow. Not the strongest wind I've ever been in, but still. I'm not too keen on camping by these trees. So I survived the storm last night, which 60 mile per hour gusts of wind. Trees didn't fall over, luckily. No, there's nowhere to charge your stuff. That's what the solar panel out. There's no electricity sockets, which I really need to charge all my stuff up, but there isn't any, so. And it's not easy to charge stuff up this time of year with the solar. I can charge up one battery maybe for the whole day, but that's it. That's not enough for all the gear I got. Links tour. It's supposed to be the most beautiful tour in Dartmoor, and it's also one of the highest points in the whole of the south of England. Shit, it's not good. Okay. it's a nice, morning here on the tour. It's supposed to be snowing later on, and in the week it's going to be snowing. It reached as low as a 0 Celsius last night. It's about 1.5 Celsius at the moment. And it's supposed to be snowing later on. It'll definitely be snowing up here because this is one of the highest points, in, as I said, in the whole of England, south of England. So
today it's not windy at all, really. No rain at the moment. It's supposed to be snowing later. That's absolutely stunning, mate. Frost, I can see. I think it did actually snow last night, but it hasn't settled. I can see snow on the ground, so it actually snowed last night. I thought it did, so I could hear the rain sounded a bit funny, and I thought, well, it's at the time it was 1 Celsius on the thing and it was raining. Well, you think at that temperature it's probably gonna be like wet snow. So there's a little fireplace here, you can have a fire. Oh, I didn't feel like having a fire last night, so I just came back up to the tent now. So I hope you enjoyed the tour, to start getting ready. There's a fair amount of wind shelter, but it's not perfect. But if you've got a really good tent, you should be okay. You want a four season tent for this time of year. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna better get ready to put the tent down. Just packed tent up, ready to go, and make sure everything zips up. Got my rubbish bag there. Bit lighter than it was before. Just coming down from Great Links tour, heading towards Brat tour down there. The views today are absolutely stunning. The weather's supposed to be not too bad. We just had that really bad day of wind. I had to go to a campsite. Been really lucky with the weather. Bit different to when I was up here the other day. The wind was bloody crazy the other day. It's nice now. I don't know how cold it is, because it feels warm, but I've got loads of layers on. Be nice to see Brat Hall in good weather. Before it was just misty when I was up here. Fantastic view. Park at Brat's Hall with the famous cross. And as you can see, there's loads of These, I don't know what they are, ponies, donkeys or horses, I have no idea, but there's loads of them. To show you, there's some over here as well. Absolutely tons of them.
Mark just coming down Brat Hall to get the bus. Unfortunately, I've got to go to Tavistock when the weather's bloody good to charge my stuff. If that bloody campsite had sockets, I wouldn't have to waste my day at the library. It's the last time I stop at a campsite here. Pointless. You know, pay for a bloody shower, 10 quid just to have a shower. What's the point? £10 for a shower. No electricity plugs. What a rip-off. That's a lot of money for me, £10. Can't afford to fucking
You know, £10, what's that? That's like, I don't know, 8 packets of OK noodles. Spicy noodles. Korean noodles. Maybe not the healthiest of food, but still, that's some munches to eat on camping. That's just, what, 10 quid? Just give it away, basically, almost. Practically give it away. Never again, mate.
At the tour, right next to Princetown, the closest one. And just walking. I was thinking of camping here, but it's too early. Just at a cross. I'm not sure what the cross is called, but at some point it had been chopped in half and they've stuck it back together with some iron. So I don't know what happened there. I'm up here. You join me at an abandoned hostel, I think. Looks like an abandoned hostel. Looks like a good place to camp, actually. Don't know if you're allowed to camp here. It's a great place to camp. Quite busy. Weather's really good. I think I'm going to carry on and go and put the tent up on a tour. Some of the lakes, there's a tour up that way. Cheers, mate. Bit of shallop. Maybe some snow in the night, because apparently it's supposed to be snowing tonight and tomorrow. And I'm over 400 metres high, so I've got my tent up just in time for sunrise. Whereas Dartmoor is big, but it's nowhere near as big as the Lake District. Lake District takes at least four OS hiking maps, whereas this only takes one.
Where I'm at, but it's just been snowing, so I'm about to melt some snow to put in my water bottle to keep warm. Now, I'm not sure how long this is going to take to melt, so you have to keep putting snow in as it melts.
It reached as low as -4 last night. It looks like a storm's coming this way, but have a walk up here. I love Dartmoor. Awesome. I didn't expect snow like this in Dartmoor. Not this time of year. Oh, just picked up my tent on my camping here. I can tell you, I never like putting a tent down in the snow, especially when it's below zero and I've got no gloves. It's wet snow at the moment, actually.
Well, let's do that.
Wet snow. I've got too far to go if I remember rightly. See more going the right way. Just coming to the main path now. Yeah. So I'm just looking at the tin line over here. Damn easy, I think. Let's go all the way to Princetown. I'm just walking past some older mine shafts. They look like they're actually mine shafts. Well, it's beautiful. As you can see, a lot of the route is deep in ice water. Beautiful day. Just camping at a new place, a little bit from the old place when I first got here by the river, and it's wind sheltered for tonight. It's supposed to be gale force winds, so I'm wild camping here just below Brat, but in a different place, sheltered tonight. I did want to camp again back up, maybe near
great lynx tour, but it's going to be heavy rain in the night and all day tomorrow. I really didn't fancy walking all the way down there in gale force winds and heavy rain, so I'm going for a day walk and leaving the tent back there. Probably can see behind me is Brat tour. I'm at the tour next to it this side. I can't remember what it's called up at the time. Nice little spot here to camp. I don't want to be honest. I don't camp here. It's going to be gale force, so it's going to be. Down in heavy rain. No, it's going to be heavy rain. Yeah, there's a few places to camp here actually. Have a look down there. That's hard to wait.
I have a flood running through my tent. Look, the river is starting to run through my tent because of the rain, so I'm quickly evacuating. I've got to quickly get my stuff together and get the tent down. So
she's had to move the tent because of flooding, because it was pissing down. This is the river, I think, or the mountain stream I should say, that was going through, but I'm crossing now, that was actually going straight through my tent. That was going through my tent, that stream. It's gone down a bit now, now it stopped raining. It was quite big earlier on. So basically, since I've been here, I've had gale force winds set up to 60-70 mph gusts. I've had snow, wind out to minus 4, and I know that because I've got a temperature gauge outside my tent. And last night and this morning had floods, so I had to move my tent because a mountain stream decided to go through my tent. And if I didn't move it quickly, you know, I didn't know how big that stream was going to get, and it was very wet anyway, we all stopped there. So hopefully it doesn't hammer it down tonight. I think I wanted to go and see some other tours near Princetown yesterday, but it would have been, it was cold and rain, and because of the rain it would have been snow up there. It would have been deep in snow. I've got no gloves. I need gloves. And I've got those snow pegs.